Muslims who are conducting these
Sabaji,
prayers,
you
and
will
all.
create
They
riots
want
like
a way
this.
out of this. They want to compromise. Now the problem is with if you will keep quiet, sir, the other gentleman, keep quiet. I have something to say here. I'm not here interested in a confrontation. So now the problem there is there's a lot of labor here. Gurugram, Gurgaon is a booming area. There are people who come there and work there, and they're looking for a place to pray. Friday prayers is a congregational event for those who wish to pray. And there is a shortage of mosques. The last mosque that was being built there, there is a stay order. So now they are going with appeals to the state government to give them more land and spaces to pray,
too much.
To allocate.
Sabaji, you're blaming
Nobody
the judiciary also.
So before you jump in and say things,
you're blaming the judiciary for having the stay order in place.
You know, don't talk rubbish to me, whoever you are. Whoever you
My
are.
My name is Raghav Avasthi.
One thing. They
I'm
were
a lawyer.
Nothing.
I went to a national
they were
law
attacked.
School.
Begin that. Begin. Start with that. The people were attacked and they're very scared right now. And listen, you Raghav, you just got onto TV. You just want to talk. I'm saying something different. You don't even know what you're talking about.
I know
Sometimes
what I'm talking about. I'm reading from the Constitution and Supreme Court judgments.
Buck.
Unlike you who wants to foment a riot.
I
read out a judgment. I iterated the constitutional position.
What
you just want
to
create
to
riots.
The
you want rioting in Gurgaon.
Do
so
not
that you can tell the world that India is unsafe under
for
Modi.
Solutions.
I mean, I
do
I
not
oh, is that,
the only gentleman
listen,
who is
that, is that,
riot,
is that
please,
the motive?
Please,
yeah, this
please
is the motive.
Quiet.
This is exactly what the motive
so
is.
Whose motive
These
is
people
it?
Want to create this narrative
have
so that they can write down their false experiments and say minorities in India are unsafe.
Well, let me tell you, no, no, Ashutosh Mishra, this is playing out. This is actually playing out in AMU. Okay, a bunch of students decide that they will not pull down Jinnah statue.
AMU has a
and
certain
when,
history.
No, and when people object,
AMU,
they say we
AMU
are being
has
attacked.
A certain history.
There are riots going on, etc., etc., and this is happening under Yogi. And then they single out a particular denomination. And 1 minute, I want to go back to Mr. Rizwan Ahmed. He has made a very important intervention in this debate. Now, Rizwan Ahmed Saab, you heard Sabah Naqvi and you heard Rizwan Kaiser. Do you agree with them?
I just need to tell them that nafrat ke 10 bahane aur mohabbat ka koi bhi nahi. If you say you are a Muslim, you are mukammal hayat, you are mukammal zabtae hayat. We Muslims feel proud that we have the entire way of life, entire way of behaving in society. Can't you lead by example? Can't you give a narrative which where the other community will look up to you? Why you have to get into a competitive argument? For God's sake, you are an educated woman. Talk like an educated person.
Two things
Talk
are very
like a reasonable person.
Okay, let Sabah Naqvi respond first. Let Sabah Naqvi respond.
If Sabah wants to come in, she is no issue. But then,
I'll come back.
Do not give me lectures. Don't patronize me. Do not patronize me, sir, whoever you are. Do not tell me I am a woman and talk
but
in a certain
Sabah,
way. I make strong objection to that.
Two, three things very quick.
Whoever you are, first know the name of the panelist.
Like
to everybody, you are saying whoever you are, whoever you are.
Raghav,
who are you? Who are you? To everybody, you are saying who
you
are, who
you
are. Whoever you are, what is this way of addressing a person? When you come in a debate,
ask
the panelist and talk to me by name. I am Dr. Rizwan. Talk to me by name. Talk to me by name.
This is misogyny. Do not talk to me like that, sir. You have no right. You are
this
not the
not
sole spokesperson for anyone.
You should talk like a reasonable
you
person.
You have no right to speak
don't
to me like that. You should find out why. You should find out. You should read my book called In Good Faith.
And you are bringing misogyny
you have
between.
No right
you
to speak to me like that.
You are saying people are scared. Not once you mentioned that the
wounds
have been arrested.
You are a shameful man. Shame on you to disrespect a woman.
People are in fear. They were attacked. People
okay.
are in fear.
One minute, I'm coming in. We need some order. We need some peace. We need some order.
What am I talking about?
This is the bottom line of this debate. For those who are just tuning in, we are debating a very important issue. It's an issue on which. No. This is an issue of principle. 1 minute. 1 minute. 1 minute. Shaja and me, give me 30 seconds, please. Let's lower everyone's faders. Give me 30 seconds. I need to tell our viewers what we are getting into. This debate is centered on an objection that has been raised against the Muslim community in a pocket of Gurgaon where the Friday prayers were being held in open public land. That is because the mosque was too small to accommodate the Muslims. So there was a spillover onto public land. Now, a group of individuals used force to evacuate these Muslims who were offering namaz, which is not acceptable. But after that, a debate has begun, because fearful of consequences, a backlash as violence, etc., for their own good, the Haryana chief minister has come out and said that, look, reasonable restrictions need to be imposed, and wherever there is a spillover onto the streets, that should be discouraged. People who want to conduct namaz must do it in their private spaces. Immediately, the Congress, other so-called self-styled opposition secular parties have jumped in and said that this is majoritarianism of the BJP kind, of the saffron kind. The Supreme Court is very clear on this issue. The Supreme Court cites Article 25 and Article 26, saying that reasonable restrictions can be imposed and they are not in any way violative of the rights that derive from the Constitution. The Constitution itself is very clear on this issue and says that reasonable restrictions can be applied to freedom of professing, propagating, and practicing your faith. Now, I want to ask certain panelists, why is it that Hindus, when they are denied the same right, then no one speaks, the secular lobby is quiet? When someone on this panel is saying that Muslims must not be confrontationalist, they can easily divide the time into two categories so that the mosque can accommodate the believers. There is a backlash.